Hello and welcome to another Roblox tutorial. In this video, we will go over some of the basics of the Lua programming language used in Roblox Studio. This video is the beginning of a series of videos geared towards those who are just starting Roblox development. If you are new to the channel, make sure to subscribe and like the video if you enjoyed. So, let's get started. So right now I'm in a basic base plate project in Roblox Studio, and this is perfect for what we're about to do in regards to scripting. But before we do that, I first want to go into the top bar of my project, go to View, and then I'm going to click Explore and Properties, and also the Output window. So this is my setup right here. These are just a bunch of windows that will be very useful when you are scripting or doing anything, to be honest, in Roblox. And before we make the script, let's first go over what a script is. So a script is basically a text file with many lines that the computer reads over and tries to execute. So in Roblox, a script is represented by a special object. So I'm going to go into server script service, click the plus arrow, type in script, and click script right here. So you can see in my Explorer, this is the script. And you can name it whatever you want. I'm just going to leave it as script. So you'll notice each line on a script is denoted by a number. Also, when you make a new script, every new script in Roblox has this, you have this statement, print hello world. And so if I were to run this, it does what you'd expect it to. In the bottom right, you can see in my output, it prints hello world. So print is a special command that basically prints whatever you put in between these parentheses out. So I can also do print a number. Let's print like 3. So you'll notice in the bottom right, print hello world in 3. So that's great and all, but what if I want to print, let's say, the color of the base plate? And you might be asking, oh, I could just go into workspace, then base plate, and I could see, oh, look, it's dark stone gray. I just know it from there. But what if you don't know it and you just want to print it out? The way you do this is by saying print. And I would say game.workspace.baseplate.brickColor. So what this does is whenever you want to access a object in the Roblox world, you first start with game, because that's the overlying hierarchy object, and then you go to wherever you want. So I went to game.workspace, and you see workspace right here. And then it tabs in, so you know you're going into another level of the hierarchy. And I do dot base plate. And then I access a property of a base plate, which is brick color. So every object in Roblox has properties. They're all in this properties window. And you can change them in here, but you can also change them in your code. But for right now, we're just going to print it out. So if I were to run this, you can see that it prints dark stone gray, which is indeed the color of our base plate. So if I were to just change it to like green, just to show you, it's green. It kind of hurts my eyes, but you can see it prints lime green. That's exactly what you want. So now let's actually change a property of our base plate using code. So the way you do this is you would first access the base plate again, and then we want to access a property of it. So let's say I want to change the transparency, which is basically like how much you can see the part. And so this is a value from 0 to 1, with 0 being completely opaque and 1 being completely transparent. So if I change it to 1 in the properties, you can see it changes. So let's just say I want to make it translucent, which would be around 0.5. So if I were to run this, you can see it's kind of transparent. I can see some of the clouds beneath it. So you may notice that when we were making our script, print properties and changing properties, this leads to long lines of code that are not very pleasing to the eye and would take a long time to write if you're doing it repeatedly. So there's a very easy workaround to this, and it's using something called variables. So a variable in Roblox is defined by saying local and then whatever the name of the variable you want it to be. So you can make it whatever. I'm going to say base plate. And this will be equal to game.workspace.baseplate. So now I have my base plate variable. So what I can do now is I can delete this and say baseplate.brickColor. So it'll print baseplate.brickColor. And I can change this line right here to say baseplate.transparency. So if I were to run this, it would do the exact same thing as it did before, but you'll notice our lines of code are a lot shorter, and all we had to do is add one extra line. So basically what this variable does is it stores a reference to our base plate that we have in the workspace, and we can access the properties, we can print them, and we can change them, which is great. And variables can also store stuff like numbers. So I can say local my number will be equal to 0.5. So this is just a basic number in Lua. And I can set baseplate.transparency to my number. And this will be using this baseplate variable and my number variable. Because the script will read it as game.workspace.baseplate.transparency equals 0.5. Because it'll say, oh, look, my number, and then my number's right here, and it says it's 0.5. So we just have to do that. So if I play it again, you will see that it has changed as well. So in the same way that variables allow you to reuse certain references or numbers in any context that you want, there's also these things in Lua called functions. So local function, my function. And I can put parentheses. So this is the syntax for a function, which basically means how you write it. So you see local, it's just like a local variable, except I have this special keyword function that makes it a function. And then I have the name of my function, some parentheses that we'll get to later, and an end. And whenever you make a function, make sure to make your first line into it indented. And this is not necessary, but it's very useful for code readability a little bit later. So functions are capable of running code snippets many times. So let's say I want to set the baseplate.transparency with my function. And so I can say baseplate.transparency to 0.3. Instead of saying baseplate.transparency many, many times throughout my script, I can just call my function. And the way you do that is by typing the name of the function and then putting parentheses. So this will run the function. So the code, the script will go through all of these lines. It'll come to this line right here and say, okay, the user wants to run my function. It goes up to my function and then runs this line right here and whatever other lines that you have in your function. So if I were to run this, you can see the base plate is a little less transparent than it was before, since we set it to 0.3. And by itself, this type of function is pretty useful, but you can add another layer of usability to your functions by using parameters or arguments. You can call them whatever you want. And they're just basically variables that you can give to your function to change its functionality. So I can put my parameters back up on the local function, my function, I can put them within the parentheses. So I can say transparency. And then what I can do with this is I can take this variable right here and paste it where 0.3 would be. So what this will do is whenever we call my function, depending on whatever number, so let's just put 1 right here, depending on whatever number I put in my function, it'll change the baseplate.transparency to the transparency that I sent. So it's basically saying, okay, we're calling my function, they send this number 1, and this function's like, okay, I got a variable for whoever sends whatever number, so then I can set the transparency to the transparency that they sent. So if I were to run this, you can see it's completely transparent. You can't see it because I set the transparency to 1. And this allows you to do stuff like I can call my function again and instead put 0.1. If we run this, you can see it changes it to 1 and then changes it to 0.1. And you'll notice that calling my function twice is a lot quicker to write than just calling baseplate.transparency. Both of these do the same thing. The only difference is we're using a function. And so functions are essential whenever you're programming in any language, to be honest. And they just allow you to repeat your code snippets. So that's about it for this video. It was very simple, but you gotta start somewhere. So make sure to comment down below if you enjoyed this basic tutorial, and make sure to ask any questions in the comments below, any more suggestions. This is a new thing I'm trying, so I would really appreciate your feedback. So make sure to like and subscribe if you enjoyed, and stay tuned for the next videos of my Roblox beginner scripting tutorial. So I hope you guys have a nice day, and goodbye.